If you are tired of using MIUI or the updates have stopped, you might want to flash a custom ROM on your Xiaomi, Redmi or a Poco device. There are a lot of options available at the moment, but if you want a Pixel-like experience, you should check the official Pixel OS. It is one of the best Pixel-based custom ROMs available right now, and I am going to show you the official method of flashing it on any Xiaomi, Redmi or a Poco device in 5 simple steps. This is going to be an extensive guide because the installation method is different for different devices. So keep your phone ready, switch on your laptop or a PC, and let's get started. Step number 1 is unlocking the bootloader. I have posted a video about it, which is pretty old, but it should be able to help you out. And there are actually plenty of videos available on YouTube, so it should not be that difficult. When you are done with unlocking the bootloader, you need to enable developer options by heading over to the About section of your device, followed by typing the build number multiple times until you see the "You are a developer now" message. Then you need to open additional settings and enable USB debugging under developer options. Step number 2 is downloading the correct files for your phone, and this is one of the most important steps. See, I am using Redmi Note 10 Pro, and the steps for this device are very easy and straightforward. I don't need any extra files to flash Pixel OS, but you might need them if you are using a different device. So please make sure you have all the required files, otherwise things might get messed up. One simple but a very important step that you need to follow is to visit Pixel OS website, search and open the link for your device, and scroll down to instructions, and this is where you will find the name of every file that you need for flashing the ROM. I will be using Pixel OS Recovery in this video, so please go through the instructions that mention Clean Flash, Pixel OS Recovery, or they might also mention AOSP Recovery. When you get to know the files that you need, scroll up to check the download links, and you will probably find 4 download buttons. One is the recovery, second is the latest Pixel OS ROM, third is for the previous builds, and the fourth one would be the XDA page. Click on the first download button and it might take you to the SourceForge website, where you will find the recovery and any additional file that's required for your device. Please go ahead and download them on your PC. If there is any missing file, you simply check the file path and click on the previous folder level and should be able to find everything. If you still find anything missing, you can click on the fourth download button. That will take you to the XDA page, where you will find the links to almost everything. Now click on the second download button to get the latest version of Pixel OS. Or if you want to flash any older version of the ROM, then please use the third download button. Apart from all these important files, you also need to download platform tools on your PC. To keep things simple and organized, please copy and paste all the downloaded files inside a separate folder. Step number 3 is to extract the platform tools folder. Then copy every file that you have just downloaded and paste them inside the extracted platform tools folder. This includes the recovery, custom ROM, firmware and all other extra files that might be required for your device, like vendor boot or the boot image. Step number 4 is taking your phone to fast boot mode, but we are not going to do it physically. We are going to use our PC to do it. And that will also make sure both the ATB and the fastboot connections are working fine. If you are an expert and you are sure that everything is fine, you can use the manual method by restarting the phone, followed by pressing and holding the volume down plus power button for a couple of seconds until you see the fastboot screen. But if you are a beginner, you can connect the phone to your PC, open the extracted platform tools folder on your PC, type CMD in the address bar and hit enter. This should open a command prompt window. Now type the first command, that is ADB space devices, and hit enter. This will confirm if the device is connected through ADB mode, and should be able to see the device ID in the command prompt window. You might also receive a pop-up about allowing USB debugging, so please keep an eye on your device. Next, you can type ADB space reboot space bootloader and hit enter. This will take your phone to fastboot mode. When you see the fastboot screen on your phone, type another command, that is fastboot space devices, and hit enter. You should get an ID similar to the one you got while using the ADB command. If everything goes well, it means that both the ADB and the fastboot connections are working fine. But if you see any issues here, you might need to double check the USB cable, USB port, or in some cases the USB drivers. If you are facing any issue with the USB drivers, I'll place some links in the video description that should be able to help you out. Step number 5 is all about flashing. Let me tell you a simple but a very important tip about flashing anything in the command prompt. If your phone is connected to the PC through fastboot mode and you want to flash any image file, then the command goes like fastboot space flash space name of the file, then one more space, and simply drag the file that you want to flash inside the command prompt window and hit enter. Now most of the files that are required at this particular step are image files. Recovery is an image file, vendor boot is an image file, boot file is also an image file. Let's say you want to flash a vendor boot file, so the command that you will use should go like fastboot space flash space vendor boot, that's the name of the file, then one more space, then drag the vendor boot file and hit enter. So it is very important to use the correct commands. For my Redmi Note 10 Pro, I don't need to flash anything except the recovery. So I will type fastboot space flash space recovery space drag the recovery file and hit enter. Now the recovery file is flashed onto my device. Next, I will boot my phone to recovery. I will type fastboot space boot space drag the recovery file and hit enter. When the phone is booted to recovery, I will go to the recovery interface. Then I will format the data by going to factory reset, then format data. Next, I will flash the MIUI 14 firmware through ADB sideload. On PixelOS recovery, I will navigate to apply update, then apply from ADB. On my PC, I will open the command prompt window and type ADB space sideload space and drag the MIUI firmware file and hit enter, and the flashing will start. Next, I will flash the ROM using ADB sideload. On PixelOS recovery, tap on apply update and select apply from ADB. On my PC, I will open the command prompt window that's already open, and I will type ADB space sideload, then one more space, and drag the custom ROM zip file and hit enter, and the flashing will start. When the flashing is complete, you can reboot the phone and it should boot into PixelOS. And that's it. You have successfully flashed PixelOS on any Xiaomi, Redmi or a Poco device. If you face any issues or if you have any queries, you can drop a comment and I'll be happy to reply. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.